your appliance and system. So please tell your appliance and systems you like something, and if you like, you can adopt it. Okay? Are you ready to take notes? Because understand, we work in the field of nutrition, supplementation, fitness, and it is not necessary for any one of you to be a nutritionist or an expert on nutrition. But if you understand why we do what we do, it will make your job easier and you can do a better job of telling people about health and nutrition. So time to take notes, because ideally in this half an hour and in subsequent half an hours, I will give you concentrated information. The idea is to make a training where you are developing skills and knowledge simultaneously. Okay? So you see, nutrition is confusing. When you talk to a doctor, when you talk to your family members, when you talk to somebody in the family, everybody has a different interpretation of what nutrition is. What I want to tell you is that on one hand, we are told how to eat healthy and maintain a healthy weight for the last 50 years. But on the other hand, the rates of obesity and diabetes are improving tremendously. So we know what we are told by my colleagues, doctors, by nutritionists, by scientists, is maybe okay theory. But in practice, it is not working, because more and more people are developing diseases. More and more people are putting on more weight than they should, in spite of the fact that they understand that they have choices to eat healthy, exercise, drink a lot of water, yet things are not working. And I will tell you the interesting thing, that medicine is also focused on helping people improve their health and optimize weight. So if you understand, in 1960, 1100 articles were published on obesity or diabetes in recognized allopathic medical journals. Last year, it was 44,000. Which means every day, almost over 100 new articles are being published in medical journals talking about obesity and diabetes. So it's not something that is happening overnight. Every day, new 100 articles. Imagine the amount of information around the world. And I want to concede this information and make it easier for you, because not every one of you will have the patience to go through all the 600,000 articles which have been published in the last 50 years. 600,000 articles, which means 1,000 articles every year on an average. And this, we are talking about 1960 to now. So there is so much information. Much of it is misinformation, but some of it is scientifically validated. Yet, we have a challenge. This information is not helping people improve their health. But you and I can actually help them. Because you look at a person who is overweight. He is bombarded by information. He is bombarded by advice. His maid will give him advice. His driver will give him advice. His sister will give him advice. His mother-in-law will give him advice. His wife will give him advice. His doctors will give him advice. His plumber will give him advice on what to do. But the question is, in spite of being flooded with advice, he is not getting better. There has to be a reason. And the reason is, we complicate things. So today I want to tell you why nutrition is simple, and why any one of you, whether you are a housewife, whether you have education, whether you are not educated, whether you have a student, you can do Herbalife business, because it is simple. We have made it simple and easy for you. Please understand, everybody wants to be well till they die. And that concept is called wellness. So everybody needs wellness. Now, where does wellness come from? Nutrition. And where does nutrition come for most of us? From Herbalife products or from other foods that we eat, after understanding what is good for us, what is bad for us, what is not so good for us, what is not so bad for us. We follow the concept of wellness rather than of treating disease. This morning, I was talking to an active world team from Patna who called me. All he was talking about was disease. So I told him, my friend, In Herbalife, you are not supposed to talk about disease. You are supposed to talk about wellness. You are supposed to talk about better health, better energy, better nutrition. So his many questions were, what can I do to treat this disease and what can I do to do the disease? I said, leave that to doctors. Your job is to prevent disease. And that is what I am telling you. As Herbalife Associates, your job is to prevent disease. Now, wellness, the industry when we work, you must know what it means. It means we have to learn and then practice what we learn, things that will help us have optimum health. We don't want to be six packs all the time, but we don't want to look or feel tired, lack of energy, irritated all the time. We don't want to be yawning in a training. We don't want to feel like sleeping. We don't want to feel like eating. We want to have vitality, strength, and energy during this training and all the trainings for wellness to come. And wellness, unfortunately or fortunately, is not about how you look. It is also about how you think. It is about how you feel. Are you capable of doing some exercise on a regular basis? Whether it is walking, whether it is running, whether it is going to the gym, whether it is lifting weights. So please understand, you have to focus as a Herbalife associate and as a part of the among the best trained teams in India. You have to think of mind, you have to think of body, you have to think of fitness, you have to think of spirit. When all these combine, you feel well. WHO in 1948, before any one of us was born, defined health as physical well-being, mental well-being, and social well-being. In the last 73 years, since India has been independent, this definition has not changed. Today also, definition of mental health and physical health are correlated according to WHO. And so please understand, don't just focus on looking good. Focus on being good, being on feeling good. And that is when health is there. If you have to think about health, think of five different things. First, are you happy? Two, do you sleep well? Three, are you drinking enough water to stay hydrated? Fourth, is your diet good enough for you to meet your daily nutritional requirements and your working requirements? And fifth, are you in a position or are you doing exercise regularly so that you tone up your muscle, you release the feel happy hormones and you feel happy? So if you have to think about health, think of five distinct things: happiness, sleep, water, hydration, diet, and exercise. Unfortunately, people think of health differently. 94% people think just because they are physically healthy, they are healthy, which is not true. People feel if they are not mentally disturbed, they are healthy. Again, not true. Incomplete. Yes, it is important to have mental health and peace of mind, but that is not what health and wellness is. If you look good, it doesn't matter how sick you are healthy. Another mistake. And if people make enough money, they feel they are healthy and well. That is also not true. You have to combine physical health, mental health, personal appearance, and financial health. And guess who offers this opportunity? When you look at Herbalife business, you are given physical health, mental health, your appearance improves, and your financial health improves. All the things that people are looking for, Herbalife gives you in one single shot. Surveys think, when asked about why are you overweight, what people think? Majority of the people, over 30%, one third of people think it is hereditary, which is not true. It is hereditary combined with current habits. People think with age they should gain weight, again not true. They do gain weight, but they should not gain weight. Food consumption, only 15% people believe that food is responsible for their being obese or overweight. Again, a very big myth. 80% of health is nutrition. And a lot of women believe that because they have had children, they should be fat and overweight. Again, not truth. If you look at Lovelina, she has had two daughters and she is still the same weight as she was maybe 50 years back. So please don't mix up weight, obesity, and genetics. They contribute to each other. But the important thing is you need to change people's thinking as Herbalife distributors. So this training today is different because I want you to focus on the challenges you will face when you do what I tell you to do in the next trainings. Talk about the product, talk about how to retail product, talk about how to get more customers, talk about how to do 2,500 volume point on a customer base. They are all founded on you first understanding why nutrition and supplementation is so important and what are the challenges you face. So many people, when you ask them, are you sick? They say, no, we have no diabetes, we have no blood pressure, we have no tuberculosis, we have no heart disease, but they have no energy. They are feeling sleepy all the time. They cannot focus on work. Are they healthy? The answer is no. So please understand, we can be not so well without having a disease. Of course, if you have a disease, you will not feel well. But if you don't have disease, you still can be unwell because you are prematurely tired, prematurely fatigued, prematurely aging. You have always said that exercise is 20% of health, diet is 80%. But I want you to change that thinking today and add one more thing. If your mindset is not 100%, 80% diet and 20% exercise will not help. So if you are a Herbalife associate and you have to guide somebody, you have to teach them over a period of time to change their mindset. If they are not thinking properly, they will not diet properly, they will not exercise properly, they will not listen to you. Which is why today I want to do a training which maybe most of you have not even thought of ever seen, is to talk about the challenges we face. Before we do that, let me tell you this, that even plants need nutrition. Behind me, you see a photograph of our lawn. This is my home. And in the lawn, we have a Buddha statue, which is a fountain really. And it is absolutely lush green thanks to Lovelina's effort. But to come to this current stage, it took 3 years of care. Now, when we start Herbalife, we want instant result. We drink a shake and we want to lose 1 kg. We use one sachet of skin booster and our skin should be perfect. That is not going to happen. It takes time. Everything takes time. But please understand, if a plant needs nutrition, if an animal needs nutrition, do you think human beings, which are the highest form of evolution, need nutrition? And the answer is an absolute yes. There are hundreds and thousands of symptoms of nutritional deficiencies. I don't know whether you know this, but there are over 5,400 minerals recognized by International Mineralogy Association. Of course, 5 are critical for human beings, but there are 5,400 minerals that are available in this earth. Now, good nutrition, wellness, bad nutrition, not so well. If you want to behave well, you need to be well nourished. If you have to take a decision, the biggest strength you will get is when your diet is good. Vitality, the capacity to work, growth, fertility, longevity, performance, learning, understanding, everything is dependent on how well nourished you are. The diet has a very, very, very important role in our lifelong performance today, tomorrow, and day after. Now, who needs more nutrition? People who have jobs, people who have unhealthy work environments, passive and active smokers, alcoholics, people who are exercising on a regular basis, people who are elderly, pregnant and lactating women, people who have bad health. If you look at this slide, you will realize 100% of Indian population needs more than average nutrition. Forget average nutrition. Those of us who have jobs need better nutrition. Those of us who exercise regularly need better nutrition. Those who are beyond, say, 65, 70 need better nutrition. Women need nutrition, men need nutrition, children need nutrition. Everybody needs enhanced nutrition, and that is the business we are in. Now, people find excuses not to change. So I wanted to start with a cartoon before I go into the science, which is a husband telling his wife, who is a fitness expert. So it is Anil Nadir telling Lovelina Nadir, if I lose 10 pounds, every woman in the neighborhood will be chasing me. Is that what you want? So people who don't want to lose weight are coming up with silly, scientific, illogical, logical excuses. But the fact of the matter is, if your spouse is fit and you're not fit, or if you become fit and you become more attractive, there is a challenge. So this was a joke to start with, but basically our challenge is we want to eat enough. Please understand, if you eat less, you will gain weight. We have to drink enough water. Whether you like it or not, WHO in 2000 said supplement diets world over. So if a diet in Europe has to be supplemented, if a diet in America has to be supplemented, if a diet in Australia has to be supplemented, do you not think a diet in India needs to be supplemented? So people who, when you retail to them, talk about supplementation, they might feel you are trying to sell something. But the fact of the matter is, everybody needs supplementation. We need to eat whole foods, food as God made them, not as housewives make them. We need to limit sugars, and all of us need to stay active. By the way, staying active doesn't mean you leave the training. Staying active means you exercise on a regular basis in the morning when you get up. So first thing, eating too little causes weight gain, eating too much causes weight gain. And the first principle of health management we taught you was ask a customer to cut back 500 calories per day. Now please understand, they have to eat correct for their weight. So you cannot expect a 60 kg person to eat the same amount of food as a 130 kg person does. 130 kg person is what I tell patients or customers is, you are a truck. Can you run on Maruti 800 fuel? Answer is no. You are a sardi. Can we wash you with the water required for a handkerchief? No. So eat right for your current weight. When you start losing weight, you adjust the calorie intake, the protein intake, and the fat intake to your current weight. So a 130 kg person has to eat for 130 kgs. It is like him going to a tailor and saying, oh, I met Raju ji. I'm going to lose 60 kg weight. So will you make me a pant which will fit me after 60 kg weight loss? It is not going to work. When he goes to a tailor, he gets a pant made for current weight. When he starts losing weight, he or she will get clothes made according to current weight. Similarly with calories, you have to eat for current weight. If you cut back 500 calories, and I will tell you calorie calculation in a subsequent training, how do you decide how many calories to eat for a person based on his or her weight? You cut back 500 kilocalories, but remember, you cut back 40% from diet and burn 60% more. So combine cutting back on food and increasing exercise. So out of 500 calories, he should burn an extra 300 calories or she should burn an extra 300 calories. You can cut back on 200 kilocalories. Unfortunately, most people that we see are not eating enough. Just because they are overweight, especially because they look overweight, they stop eating and they think by eating less, they will lose fat. But what happens? When they start eating less, they become rounder and fatter because what is called a famine instinct kicks in. And Raju ji yesterday had posted a wonderful video which also talked about why overeating doesn't cause fat. It is because you are fat, you stop losing the capacity to not eat. So if you haven't seen that video, ask Raju ji for the video and see it. It is very nice. It was in the President Team group. But he will give it to you. So practice the 40-60 split, which means exercise 60% more, cut back 40% in your diet. Now, allergy, calorie in, calorie out depends on too many factors. That is why in 2015, the science said shift focus from how many calories you are eating. Focus on where the calories are coming from. If the calories come from a bad food, it is better not to eat them in spite of the fact that it is meeting your calorie requirement. So a 70 kg person can eat his 2100 calories from ice cream, or he can eat it from apples, or he can eat it from chicken, fish and meat. You have to decide which is 2100 calories are the same, but the 2100 calories from ice cream are not so good. While it's balanced fruits and vegetables and chicken and fish and meat, they are far better than just getting those calories from ice cream or laddu or whatever, Mysore pak. So please understand, calorie is not the villain. The source of calorie is the villain if you have to manage weight. We tell you to drink 20 liters water per kilogram body weight, but it depends also on exercise. So it is not 20 calorie kilos per liter. It is 20 calories equals to 1 liter plus the sweat factor. Always add what the sweat loss is when you are exercising. Everybody knows staying healthy means eat organic food, drink and bathe with clean water, and live in an air where it is clean. Now I live in the most polluted city in the world, Delhi. How can I control air? I might drink water out of a bottle, a Bisleri thing, but when I brush my teeth, it is with the municipal water. When I have a bath, it's with municipal water. When I wear a shirt, it has been washed with municipal water. The food that I eat, including the shake that I eat, if I am not using a disposable glass, the water is washed with municipal, the glass is washed with municipal water. How do I know it's clean? And eating organic food, in India, there is no company or no organization that certifies that food is organic. Let us assume if somebody is selling you organic food, he's saying the truth. It is true to 10 times more expensive to buy organic food than regular food. So in a country where economics is important, organic food is by and large very, very expensive. And we are not sure whether it is organic or not. So it's easy for people to say, what is the problem in staying healthy? Eat organic food, breathe clean air, use clean water. But all three are only theoretical. In practice, it is very, very tough. So I just told you, a calorie is not a calorie. A calorie that comes from broccoli is not the same as calorie it comes from an ice cream cone. Both might have 150 calories, but the source of calorie determines the quality of calorie, not the calorie itself. Now, everybody knows in our diet, and I hopefully one day in training, I will explain the global nutrition philosophy of 30, 40, 30 to you. But today you just take, we need a balance of protein, carbohydrate, fat. The reality is, carbohydrate is the cheapest component of food. So most people eat only carbohydrate, carbohydrate, carbohydrate. Protein is the most expensive component of food in terms of how much you need. So chicken, fish, meat are more expensive than potatoes. In vegetarian food, the pulses, dal and cheese is more, paneer is more expensive than say raw vegetables in season. And fat, of course, desi ghee is of course 500, 600 rupees a kilo. But you don't eat a lot of it. So fat is the intermediate cost of expensive. But science says balance all three. You need all three in particular measurements. But we don't get it. We don't get it because of A, we are used to eating whatever we are eating. For example, you live in a city or an area where the dosa is a pesaretu. But if you go down south, they don't eat pesaretu. In Delhi, we have a Tamil restaurant that serves it. But basically, they would like you to eat rava masala dosa. So obviously, the food changes every 200 kilometers in India. And I will show it a slide to you, which will explain this. But please understand, getting the three micronutrients, macronutrients in the right proportion is a big challenge for every human being, including Herbalife Associates. And this challenge you have to learn to overcome by trainings and knowing what is correct. What is correct is written on this. Science says, if you want to build a body and you're already not overweight, most of your diet should be a combination of carb, protein, and fat. If you want to maintain weight, make sure you get 25 to 35% protein and 25 to 35% fat. And if you want to lose fat, make sure your diet is 40 to 50% protein. And it has 30 to 40% fat. So if you look at this slide, you will understand that at least 25% of your calories should come from fat. At least 25 to 40% should come from protein. And carbohydrate can be between 10% to 60%. But like I told you, most Indians eat 80%, 90% carbohydrate. They don't eat enough protein, and this is borne out by hundreds of surveys that are carried out worldwide. Also in this country, there is a challenge between wheat eaters and rice eaters. From a scientific point of view, rice eating, which for some peculiar reason was supposed to be obesity inducing, is not, is preferred to wheat eating. But if you look at this map of India, this is a rice eating country. 15% plus are rice eaters, of course, in areas of extreme west. So if you look at Rajasthan, if you look at maybe Madhya Pradesh, some portions, if you look at Uttar Pradesh and Punjab for sure, they are wheat eaters. But predominantly this country is rice eaters, and you are in a belt which is all purple, which is the rice eating belt. And by the way, rice is healthier than wheat nutritionally. Secondly, when we compare veg with non-veg, we have a challenge because most people think we should be vegetarians. The national average is 29% only, and that also again in the wheat growing areas. If you look at your area, South India, or maybe anything down the Vindhyas, it is predominantly non-vegetarian. So you are getting some protein from the diet. But non-vegetarian doesn't mean you eat meat three times a day. It means when given a choice, you eat non-veget. If Rajuji is hosting a party to celebrate his 30K and ask you what you want for dinner, you say chicken, fish, meat and egg. But when you eat yourself, you may never ever eat that much food. So please understand, we have a challenge of the highest order. Indian Medical Research Bureau and other surveys have shown that 90% of Indians don't get adequate protein. 90%. So if on the call we are, I don't know how many people, maybe 200 people, you can easily safely assume that 180 of you are not getting enough protein from your diet. Thank God for Herbalife, and thank God for Herbalife Shake that you get it. You look at the survey that shows 97% pregnant women don't know how much protein they need. They don't know that 70% of women believe proteins are available in fruits and vegetables. There is virtually no protein in fruits and vegetables scientifically, 3%, 4%. But women believe, pregnant women, and why I'm including pregnant women is because pregnancy, you pay attention to what you eat and drink, because everybody says, oh, you have to eat for a baby, you have to be worried about a baby, you have to do all that stuff. So please understand, there are myths around it. When you look at the countrywide situation, you people in the South are not any better than India in protein. 75% of men don't get enough protein, 72% of women. So please understand, as a country, we face protein deficiency. This is the bread map of India. In the US, you go from one and another to another, you will get bread, croissant, extreme, you will get a bagel. But look at India. While in Kashmir, where I come from, the bread is called Girda. Where you are, probably it is Rumali Roti or whatever, Appam or Malabar Paratha or Thali Peet in Maharashtra, Angkar Roti maybe. So please understand, this Akki Roti, Jalara Roti, they're all varieties of food in India. We have such a mind-boggling variety of food preparation that the challenge is we don't know what to eat and what not to eat. And everything looks delicious. So please understand, when you talk about nutrition, keep these challenges in the back of your mind. Nutrition in the crop has gone down. This data is already 20 years old, which shows that vitamin B12 in fruits and vegetables has gone down 35%. All our vegetables and plants have a lot of protein, calcium, iron. Vitamin C in palak, spinach, because Japanese have what is called a food standardized ingredient list every year. They measure the vitamin mineral content of fruits and vegetables. I chose spinach because it's a common North Indian vegetable. In 1950, it was 150 milligram vitamin C. In 2010, 3 milligram. So when you talk to a customer, explain to him, we have challenges of dietary choice, but we also have challenges that our fruits and vegetables have lost their vitamin and mineral content. Your requirement has gone up. The availability in fruits and plants has gone down. So you need supplementation. Most people say, oh, we diet religiously. It's in their mind. What they mean by diet religiously is this. They think they can eat what they like and hope it doesn't show. But that is not going to happen. So dieting religiously, yes. Not working, sure. How do you overcome these challenges? By Herbalife Nutrition. And I will talk about Herbalife Nutrition one Thursday thereafter, 21st. I will talk about some things on the product. But please understand, if you have to overcome challenges, you need support from Herbalife Nutrition. I am always grateful for your time and attention. And this is the time for you to ask questions because the half an hour, exactly half an hour is up. And you have 20 minutes to ask questions pertaining to why nutrition is important and pertaining to what I taught today. We will do at least 12 to 15 such sessions in the next 3 months where I will hope to cover simple things. If there are some things that bother you and you want to know, please tell Rajuji, we want to get trained on this and he will convey it to me and I will hopefully